Welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Ayush Jain and today I am giving a demo of passive filters. The order code of this equipment is 36134. Now this is our equipment. It contains of various circuits: low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter, M derived low pass filter, M derived high pass filter. This is our function generator and this is our oscilloscope on which we will see the waveform generated by these circuits. Now first of all, we connect our inputs through this CRO cables. We connect our input frequency to this circuit. First we take the low pass filter and output through these points. We will observe a sine wave as you can see in this CRO. Now as this is our low pass filter, it will pass the low frequencies and will give a null, give a ground at or give a straight line at high frequencies. Now first it is at 1k. Now as we increase our frequency, first of all it is at 782 hertz, as you can see in this function generator. Now when we increase our frequency, the amplitude of our waveform will decrease, as you can see, and after a certain value, that is the cutoff value, it will further decrease and become null, as you can see in the CRO. Now by seeing this value, after getting the null, after getting the cutoff frequency FC, you can see through this waveform, this is the alpha and this is the beta. We have to calculate the value of the alpha and beta. After getting the cutoff frequency FC, put the FC in this value and calculate alpha and beta. The formulas of alpha and beta are given clearly in our lab manual. So after calculating the FC, calculate alpha and beta with the help of the formulas in the lab manual. Now we move on to the next circuit. Connect the output to these points and the input to these points. Now we will again get a sine wave. Now this is a high pass filter. This means that high frequency, when I'll give the high frequency 2.3, 3 kHz, it will pass and give a constant sine wave. But when I decrease my frequency, as I decrease my frequency from 3 to 1 kHz, the sine wave, the amplitude of sine wave will decrease, and at a certain value the cutoff frequency will occur and then it will become a straight line. The cutoff frequency will occur when there is a downfall in amplitude of 3 dB, that is 0.707 volts. As you get that downfall in the amplitude, that is the cutoff frequency. Note that cutoff frequency, and with the help of these formulas you can calculate the value of alpha and beta again. There are different values for different filters, with different types of filters. The formulas for high pass filters are in our lab manual, is right here. You can calculate the values of alpha and beta through these formulas, as you can see. Now we move on to the next circuit. This is our band pass filter. Band pass filter, as the name suggests, it will pass within a certain band. It will not pass the low frequencies, neither the high frequencies. It will pass within a band of frequency. Now you can see the waveform. First of all, my frequency is around 6 kHz. Now as I at this point, it is not clearly passing. The amplitude of sine wave is very less. As I increase my frequency, the amplitude is increasing. This is the band in which the band pass filter works, that is from 8 kHz 8 kilohertz, then after again 9, after 10 kilohertz the frequency is getting less. So between 8 to 10 kilohertz is the band of the band pass filter. So get the cutoff frequency, the low cutoff frequency and the higher cutoff frequency in this band pass filter, and through the formulas which are given in our lab manual, you can see through these formulas which are given in the lab manual, we can calculate the value of alpha and beta. These are the formulas for alpha and beta for band pass filter. Calculate these values which are required in this experiment. Now we move on to the next circuit, which is M derived low pass filter. In this M derived low pass filter, this circuit works as, after the cutoff frequency is reached, still it passes a certain amplitude of sine wave continuously. So it is a low pass filter, it passes the low frequencies and blocks the high frequencies. As I it is initially it is 740 hertz, as I increase my frequency the amplitude of my sine wave is decreasing. As you can see, amplitude is decreasing, but after reaching the cutoff also it is passing a certain value. You can see it is not becoming a straight line, it is still a sine. So this is the working of M derived low pass filter. We have to find the cutoff frequency FC where the 3 dB loss is occurring. Then as we get that FC, then through this formulas we will calculate the values of F alpha M. As you can see, whatever the variables are needed, the formulas are given directly in the lab manual. Calculate through these values obtained. Now we move on to our last circuit, M derived high pass filter. The working of M derived high pass filter is that it will pass the high value and blocks the lower frequencies, but still at the lower frequency it will give a certain sine wave. It will not become a complete straight line. As it is 10k, now it will pass the high frequencies. As you can see, the amplitude is approximately same. Now when I decrease my frequency, the amplitude of sine wave is decreasing, as you can see, but still it is passing at a still it is passing a sine wave. It is not becoming null. As I decrease my frequency, the amplitude is decreasing, but still it is not becoming null. This is the function of M derived high pass filter. Calculate the cutoff frequency of this filter, and then through the given formulas in our lab manual, calculate the desired variables which are required. This is the working of the passive filter equipment. For any further information, please consult the lab manual. Thank you.